Welcome to my basic mechanical engineering playlist. Today I am going to discuss about classification of boiler. So let's see first of all the classification of the boiler according to the number of ways. First, according to the axis of drum, next according to the position of water and gas, next location of furnace, next working pressure, next according to the method of water circulation, next mobility of boiler, and at last number of tubes. So let's see one by one these all types of the classification of boiler briefly with examples. First one, according to the axis of drum, it is classified as horizontal boiler, vertical boiler and inclined boiler. If the axis of boiler drum is horizontal, it is known as horizontal boiler. Very simple, it depends on the position of the axis of boiler drum. If it is horizontal, then it is called as horizontal boiler. The example is locomotive boiler. And here you can see this is the boiler drum and the axis of the boiler drum is in horizontal position. Next, if the axis of the boiler drum is vertical, it is known as vertical boiler. Example is Cochran boiler, and here you can see this is the boiler drum and that is in vertical position, that's why it is called as vertical boiler. Next, if the axis of the boiler drum is inclined, it is known as inclined boiler, and this is the special purpose boiler. Next, according to the position of water and gas, boiler is classified as fire tube boiler and water tube boiler. If the hot gases are inside the tubes and water is surrounding the tubes, it is known as fire tube boiler. So very simple, if the hot gases are inside the tubes, it is called as fire tube boiler. Example is Cochran boiler. And here you can see inside of the tubes, there is a flue gases, or you can say the hot gases, and that's why it is called as the fire tube boiler. Next, if the water is inside the tubes and hot gases are surrounding the tubes, it is known as water tube boiler. So it is exactly opposite to this fire tube boiler. The example is Babcock and Wilcox boiler. And here you can see inside of the tubes there is a water, and that's why it is called as the water tube boiler. Next, according to the location of furnace, the boiler is classified as externally fired boiler and internally fired boiler. If the furnace is placed outside of the boiler drum, it is known as externally fired boiler. Very simple, it based on the location of the furnace. If it is outside of the boiler drum, then it is called as externally fired boiler. Example is Babcock-Wilcox boiler. And here you can see the boiler furnace is outside of this boiler drum, and that's why it is known as externally fired boiler. Next, if the furnace is placed inside the boiler drum, it is known as internally fired boiler. Example is Cochran boiler. And here you can see the boiler furnace is inside of this boiler drum, that's why it is called as internally fired boiler. Next, according to the working pressure, boiler is classified as high pressure boiler and low pressure boiler. If the pressure is more than 20 bar, it is known as high pressure boiler. The example is Babcock-Wilcox boiler, where the pressure of the steam is greater than 20 bar. And this is a figure of the Babcock-Wilcox boiler. Here inside of the boiler drum, there is a steam and the pressure of the steam is generally greater than 20 bar in case of high pressure boiler. If the pressure is less than 20 bar, it is known as low pressure boiler. Example is Cochran boiler. Here you can see the steam is accumulated in the upper part of the boiler drum, where the pressure of the steam is below 20 bar. Next, according to the method of water circulation, boiler is classified as forced circulation boiler and natural circulation boiler. If the circulation of water is done by pump, it is known as forced circulation boiler. That means if the circulation of water is done by the external sources, then it is known as forced circulation boiler. Example, Lamont boiler. See, this is the figure of the Lamont boiler where the circulation of the water is done by the pump. Next, if the circulation of water is done by density difference, then it is known as natural circulation boiler. Example is Cochrane boiler. Here, the circulation of the water in the boiler drum is by density difference naturally, and that's why it is called as the natural circulation of boiler. Next, according to the mobility of boiler, boiler is classified as stationary boiler and portable boiler. If the boiler cannot be moved from one place to another in operating condition, it is known as stationary boiler. So it is very important point. The boiler cannot be moved from one place to another place in operating condition. Then it is known as stationary boiler. Example, Cochrane boiler. So this boiler cannot be moved from one place to another place in working condition. If the boiler can move in operating condition easily, it is known as portable boiler. Example, locomotive boiler. And this type of the boiler is used in generally train, and that's why you can understand this boiler can move in operating condition. Next, according to the number of tubes, boiler is classified as single tube boiler and multi tube boiler. If there is only one fire or water tube, it is known as single tube boiler. So very simple, name itself indicate. In a single tube boiler, there is one fire tube or one water tube. Then it is known as single tube boiler. Example is Cornish boiler. See in this figure, this is the side view and this one is the front view. And here you can see in this figure, only one water tube is there, and that's why it is called as the single tube boiler. If there are two or more fire or water tubes, it is known as multi tube boiler. Example, Cochrane boiler. Here you can see number of tubes are there, and that's why you can say this is the multi-tube boiler. Thanks my dear friends for watching this video. Press the like button to appreciate.